Why Spain? Why? Hello everybody and welcome back. I'm Pascal Malchef and this is Chef's Choice. Spain decided yesterday and gave us our second official entry for the Eurovision Song Contest 2019 in Tel Aviv. First, I have to say that all of the songs have tremendously improved since we heard the demo snippets. And even live, they all sounded great and were performed really well. From all of the 10 songs, they selected Miki with Lavenda in the end. I had this song as my last place in my top 10 video about Spain's selection. And to be honest, I still think there were at least 5 better choices than this. They had so many great performances last night, especially Natalia was a superstar. And we even had the direct comparison between the two in their duet, where she was miles ahead in terms of charisma, outfit choice and vocal ability. So I'm not quite happy with this decision. But what's done is done. So let's look at the chosen entry by itself in more detail. So let's start with the positive. It will be a great song for the crowd in the arena to shake and dance and try to sing along. It's a party song that sounds like there's a soccer championship coming up. It has a lot of energy and works really well live. So even though I might not be the biggest fan of the studio version, I kind of started to like it after seeing it live. Even though I personally would have chosen another act, I can see why Spain voted for Miki. When listening to the snippets, I expected another Do It Your Lover disaster, but this is definitely better than that. But what is bad? As I said, it feels more like a sports championship song than Eurovision. That's perfectly fine, of course, but I just personally am not really into these kinds of songs in the long run, as you can quickly become weary of them. But for one night only, it could work well if it's performed right. And there I do still have some issues. I think the whole staging and performance needs a bit more sophistication. Of course, it shouldn't become a stiff black tie performance, but I think a bit of refinement and training is necessary to make it feel more professional. The band girls feel like a group of cheerleaders with instruments, and Miki looks like he just woke up. So what would I do if I were Spain's head of delegation? First of all, I would give Miki a makeover to bring out the star in him, instead of being the schoolboy next door on the soccer field. Then I would send him to a dance teacher to just learn a bit more how to control his moves. But overall, the staging was going in the right direction, so I would just like to see a refined version of that in Tel Aviv. But is it a top or flop? I'm having a hard time estimating where this will land in the end. The first time I saw it this morning, I thought they won't be able to leave the last place far behind them. But the more I hear it, the more I get into it. We still are very early with only 2 set countries, and with Spain, it's not even about qualifying or not. So based on the fact that I wasn't a big fan of the first time around and that there will be 20 acts that already survived the semi-final competing against it, I'd still say it won't leave the right side of the scoreboard, unfortunately. But I can't really be more detailed at this point. But that is also why I'm particularly interested in your opinion. How would you rate this song? Tell me in the comments below. And of course, if you like this kind of song review videos, give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see my reviews for the other upcoming 40 songs. For now, thank you so much for watching and I see you soon. Bye.